The coalition Drug Safe Utah that was opposing a Utah ballot measure to legalize marijuana has withdrawn their lawsuit. The move clears the path for November's highly contested ballot measure. But the opponents are still threatening to overturn the law if voters approve it. The measure, known as the Utah Medical Cannabis Act, would give patients in one of the nation's most conservative states the option of using cannabis for medical purposes. Joining me now to discuss the legalization fight is Taylor Anderson. He is a government reporter for the Salt Lake Tribune. Taylor, thanks for joining us.
Glad to be here. Thanks.
So why did opponents drop this lawsuit?
It was kind of an issue of the cart before the horse. They filed it saying that it was unconstitutional, but there was nothing that they were actually challenging. At this point, it's just an idea that voters will have the say on in November. So before there's actually a law to challenge, it's premature to actually challenge it in court.
Well, where does support for medical marijuana stand in the state?
It's actually sitting pretty well. It's at about 66% support. About 10% aren't really sure where they're at, and the rest is somewhat opposed or very opposed. It was 3 out of every 4 voters in support of the initiative, and that's dipped slightly in recent months.
Well, Utah has a large Mormon population. Where do members stand on the issue, and how far and how are they affecting its popularity?
That's an interesting storyline as part of this whole campaign, because several members that are running the campaign are actually active members of the church, and yet the church leadership has released several statements in opposition to this. And so it's kind of a unique dynamic where members aren't really sure what to do about it, and it looks like they're actually fairly in support. The majority of active LDS are actually supporting the measure. And the church is actually not coming out and telling its members not to vote for it or to vote against it or spend money to defeat it. They're just saying we have concerns. So they're treading lightly, and members seem to be still going along with the initiative.
Interesting. Well, how important is this issue when it comes to the midterm elections?
It looks like it might be a driver. Utah is a very conservative state. We don't have too many competitive congressional races. We do have Mitt Romney on the ballot this year, and yet it looks like he's a sure thing to win. So it's not really clear if he's going to be the driver for as far as turnout. We do have several ballot measures that appear to be headed for the ballot this year, and this is probably the most contested. So this actually might bring out more voters than any other race.
So let me ask you more about that. Mitt Romney is running for a vacant U.S. Senate seat in the state. Has he weighed in?
He has once, at least once that I've seen, during a debate against his primary opponent. He said he's not against the idea of medical marijuana. He just doesn't like this initiative. He wants something that sounds like it's more like a doctor-patient, pharmacist, like pharmaceutical-type relationship. So it's more, he said he doesn't want drugs on the street. He wants it more in the hands of doctors and pharmacists kind of thing. So he's not.
What are you watching for next in this, Taylor?
Well, you know, it's the opposition is still kind of forming, and so we're waiting to see, one, if the church is actually going to come out and tell its members, who make up 60% of the state, whether they should vote for or against or remain in the background of this. And we're yet to see a solid campaign against this thing solidify and see what kind of money might be spent to either pass or defeat it. So that's what we're looking for.
Fascinating issue in a fascinating state. Taylor Anderson, thanks very much, Taylor.
Glad to be here. Thanks.